Hi guys, welcome to this video of Time and Work. I'm Kasturi Sanup, your quantitative ability teacher. I have done my MBA from Xavier Institute of Management, Bhuvaneshwar, and have scored 98 plus percentile in my CAT, SAT, and other MBA entrance exams. So today we are going to see a concept related to time and work, wherein there are multiple laborers who are working together. So let's get started with the concept. So guys, in these kind of questions, this is one category, one bucket of questions wherein you will be told that there are five men working and seven women working together and they can do a particular work in X amount of days, or they can do 4/5 or 3/5 of work in X amount of days, and you have to calculate what is the value of X or something like that. So here you will always be given a set of people who are working together and their speed. So when you solve these kind of problem, if at all you are given that there are four different laborers who are doing a particular job in one day and you are asked what is the speed of one laborer, then always remember that the speed of one laborer is going to be 4x. So in this case, all these four laborers were taking one day to solve that particular problem or to do that particular job. So one laborer is going to take 4 days. All you have to do is you have to multiply the number of days into the number of laborers in order to calculate what is the time taken by one laborer to do that particular work. If at all you are given that there are five men who can complete a particular job in 10 days and you are asked what is the time taken by one man to do that particular job, then all you have to do is to multiply 5 with 10 and you can come to the answer, which is 50 days. So one man is going to take 50 days in order to complete that particular job. So this is a very simple concept, but mostly people confuse it by dividing it with the number of laborers. So you don't have to do that particular mistake. So you don't have to do that mistake. You have to multiply when you want to arrive at the time taken by one laborer to do a job. Now this is a formula which says that the time taken and the number of laborers working or number of people is directly proportional with the work that they do. We are going to use this formula and then you will understand how we can use this formula or what exactly this formula means. So let's get started with the questions. Now in this problem, it is given that 10 men can do a particular job in 15 days. So 10 men take 15 days to do a particular job. And we are also given that 15. And we are also given that 15 women can do the same job in 12 days. So now let us find out what is the amount of job that one man does in one single day. So now if 10 men are taking 15 days in order to do a particular job, then one man is going to take 10 into 15 days to do that particular job. Similarly, one woman is going to take 12 into 15 days in order to do that job. Now when we take the reciprocal to find out what is the amount of job that one man has done in one single day, we come to the answer 1 upon 10 into 15. Similarly, one woman can do 1 upon 12 into 15th work in one particular day. So now we have to find out what is the how many days will 5 men and 10 women take if they do the job together. So we are given 5 men and 10 women. So let us find out how much of the job will 5 men and 10 women do in one single day. All we do is we multiply the amount of job that one man does in one single day with 5 And similarly, we multiply by 10 the amount of job that one single woman will do in one day, and we just add them. So we get this expression. Now by solving, we come to the answer. So we get 4 upon 45, and we can conclude that 5 men and 10 women can together do 4 upon 45th of the total work in one single day. So total they are going to take 45 upon 4 days to do the work together. Now none of these answers match the answer that we have got, so the correct answer is none of these. Now let's see the other variation of this kind of a problem. Here we are given that 10 men and 15 women together can complete the work in 6 days. So in one particular day, they can do 1/6 of the total work. It takes 100 days for a man to complete a work all by himself. Here we are given that one man can do a work all by himself in 100 days. So in one day, one man can do 1 upon 100th of the work in one day. Now we just substitute these values to find out what is the number of days that one woman will take. So when we solve it, we get the answer 15W equal to 1/6 minus 1 upon 10. The LCM is 30. So one woman can do 1 upon 225th of the total work in one single day. So one woman will take 225 days in order to complete a particular work. So the correct answer is answer number B, option number B. Now let's see another problem. 10 men work for 8 hours in a day for 15 days to complete 4/5 of the total work. How much of the work will 15 men complete if they work for 6 hours for 15 days? Here guys, I have jotted down what is the given portion of the question. So we have P1, that is the number of laborers, it is 10. T1, which is 8 into 15. That is the time taken by each person. That is the total time taken, which is 8 into 15, because they are working for 8 hours for 15 days. And they are doing 4/5 of the total job. So my W1 is 4/5. Now we are asked how much work will 15 men, so my P2 is 15, will complete if they work for 6 hours for 15 days. So 6 into 15 is my T2. Now all we have to do is we have to substitute these values in the given formula. So we already have the value for P1, we have the value for T1, we have the value for P2, and T2 is 90. My W1 is 4 upon 5 and my W2 is X. So it is not given. Now when I substitute this, now when I solve this, I get the answer. So my W2 comes out to be 9 upon 10. So this is the correct answer. In these kind of question, all you have to do is you have to substitute the given data in this particular equation. What is the equation? The equation talks about the time taken by the total number of people is equal to the amount of work they do. So all you will be given is two set of equations, and you just have to put it into the formula and calculate the value of the unknown. Now there is another variation of the same problem, and we will have a look at that. So here you are given that 10 men work for 8 hours in a day for 15 days. So again we know that the T1 is 8 into 15, which is 120. To complete the total work, here we are not given the value of W. We are said that they are completing total 100% work. So the value of W here is actually 1, or we can say 100, because they are completing the total work, 100% of the work. How much time will 15 men take if they are working for 8 hours? Now what we do is we substitute all these numbers in our given equation and find out the value. So my T2 is actually equal to 80 hours. Now I am already given that they are working for 8 hours. So 80 divided by 8 equal to 10 days. So the correct answer is option number A. So these kind of problems are pretty simple. If at all you spot these problems, then just remember the formula. The formula is also very easy to remember, and all you have to do is put the values in the given formula and arrive at the answer. So in this video, we have seen how to solve problems which involve multiple set of laborers working together. We have one formula and we have the concept which states that if there are 5 or 6 people, n number of people who are doing a particular task in x days, then one person can do the same task in n into x days. So we have used these two concepts, we have used a formula and this concept, and we arrive at the answer. I hope you liked our video. Watch our coming videos for next concepts. Thank you.